In this video, we'll take a look at solving two absolute value inequalities. We'll express each as a compound inequality, a graph, and using interval notation. In the first example, we have the absolute value of 2x plus 3 is less than 7. So the first thing to recognize here is we're looking for values of x so that 2x plus 3 would have a distance from 0 less than 7. And since the original inequality symbol is less than, we're going to write this as two inequalities connected by the word and, which means we're looking for the intersection of two linear inequalities. The first inequality is going to be 2x plus 3 is less than 7. So notice how for this inequality, we just drop the absolute value and 2x plus 3 must be greater than negative 7. So for the second inequality, we drop the absolute value, reverse the inequality symbol, and change the sign of the 7. So now we'll solve these and then graph the intersection of the two on the number line. So here we'll subtract 3 on both sides. This would be 2x less than 4. Divide both sides by 2. So we have x is less than 2, and now we'll solve the second inequality. Subtract 3 on both sides, should be 0. So we have 2x greater than negative 10, divide both sides by 2. And we have x is greater than negative 5. So here's the solution as a compound inequality. So now we'll graph these two and look for the intersection. So we have x is less than 2. So open point on 2, arrow to the left. And x has to be greater than negative 5. So we have an open point on negative 5, arrow to the right. Now this is not the graph of our solution because we're looking for the intersection of these two intervals, which is the interval that's been graphed twice. So we can see it's going to be the interval between negative 5 and positive 2. So let's go ahead and clean this up. The graph of our solution would be this interval here, which means using interval notation, we have the open interval from negative 5 to positive 2. So we use a rounded parenthesis here as well as here to show the endpoints are not included. Now let's go and take a look at a second example. Here we have the absolute value of 3x minus 1 is greater than or equal to 5. So now we're looking for the values of x so that 3x minus 1 would have a distance from 0 that's greater than 5 units. And since the original inequality symbol is greater than or equal to, we'll have two inequalities connected by the word or. So the first inequality is going to be 3x minus 1 is greater than or equal to 5. So the first inequality, we just drop the absolute value. Or for the second inequality, we drop the absolute value, reverse the inequality symbol, so it's going to be less than or equal to, and then change the sign of the 5, so we have negative 5. So now we'll solve and graph these two inequalities, and the solution will be the union of these two intervals. So here we'll add 1 to both sides. This would be 3x greater than or equal to 6, divide both sides by 3. So we have x is greater than or equal to positive 2, or now we'll solve the second inequality. This would be 0. We have 3x is less than or equal to negative 4. Divide both sides by 3. So x is less than or equal to negative 4 thirds. So now we'll graph these. For x is greater than or equal to 2, this does include the value of 2, so we make a closed point here. Arrow to the right for the numbers greater than 2. And then for negative 4 thirds, that's going to be in between negative 1 and negative 2, closer to negative 1. Let's just say it's here. So make a closed point on negative 4 thirds. And then for values less than negative 4, we have an arrow to the left. So as we move to the right, we're approaching positive infinity. As we move to the left, we're approaching negative infinity. So using interval notation, for the interval from negative 4 thirds to negative infinity, including negative 4 thirds, we'll have negative infinity, negative 4 thirds, To show the interval includes 4/3, we'll make a square bracket here, a rounded parenthesis on negative infinity. Or, instead of using or, sometimes you'll see texts use u for union. It means the same thing. And then the interval from 2 to infinity, including 2, will be closed on 2. And then we'll use a rounded parenthesis on positive infinity. Okay, that's going to do it for these two examples. I hope you found this helpful.